Hello friends, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this tutorial, we will see how we can create the user prompts and the filters in the IDT tool. So, in the IDT tool, it is possible to create the user prompts and the filters in the business view layer. So, the prompt is defined in the business layer or the data foundation that requires a user input, or it can take the predefined input value. So we can have the different types of prompts. So either it can take the user input as a response, or we can give a predefined fixed value. So let's see in the tool how we can create the prompts. So if I open up the IDT tool and if I use the same universe which we have seen in the previous tutorial. So here in the, if I go in the BLX layer, which is my business layer. So here we have the option of parameters and the list of values. So if I go to the parameters and click on new, here I can give the name of the parameter. Let's say if I give the demo underscore param. So I can make it hidden by choosing this checkbox. I can give any description if I want. And after that, here in the prompt options, we can choose either prompts to the user or not. So if we choose the, it will not prompt to the user. It means that we have to pass the value as a constant, or we have to write down any formula. But if we want the user to provide an input to it, so we have to select this, the prompt to user. So here you have to give the prompt text. So this text will be visible to the user. So let's say if we give the, enter the value to the parameter. After that, what is the data type, whether it's date, date time, numeric or string. Then do we want to allow the multiple values to be passed, or do we want to keep the last value selected? So based upon our requirement, we have to check or uncheck these check boxes. After that, do you want to associate any list of values with this parameter? So if you click on here, and it will show you the list of all the different business values which are there in your repository. So these are all the list of values which we have. So based upon the business layer object. So we can associate any of them based upon the requirement with our prompt. After that, we have the default values. So whether we want to set the default values. So do we want to put it as a constant, or do we want to put it as a formula? So we have to, based upon this, we have to set the default values. So once you will click on save all, so this parameter will appear under the parameters in your business layer. And if you go here and if you export the business layer again to the repository, so your users, they will be able to see this user prompt when they will use this BLX or the business layer in any of the reporting tool. So it will be a drag and drop value available to the end users, so that they can just drag it in their reports and they can use it as a prompt. So this way you can create the parameters in the IDT tool using the different objects in your universe. Thank you.